find magnesium to be really helpful supplement. Now, if you can't move your bowels, you look for a magnesium oxide. All right, that will help move the bowels. However, if you don't want to spend all day on the toilet, then you go for like a magnesium citrate, glycinate, taurate. There's a whole bunch of different good ones. Threonate, which is the one that crosses the blood-brain barrier. Those are good forms. And then eat trace mineral-rich foods. When you eat real foods, and you can go to the next slide, eat real foods. And these ones right here are the best when it comes to trace minerals. You can go to the next slide. These ones are the best when it comes to trace minerals. So these should be a part of your diet, or at least getting a majority of these. There may be something here that you have a food sensitivity to, or there may be something you just don't like. That's fine if you keep that out, but try to get a majority of these. And I would imagine most of you guys, like how many of you guys ate at least three of these yesterday? All right, so probably just about everybody here. So make sure that you're getting a lot of these trace mineral-rich foods in your diet when you are eating, and that will really help you. Salt your foods to taste. You don't need to oversalt them, but salt them up to your flavor profile, and that's really helpful as well. Now, let's go ahead and go to the next slide there. Now, this is how we troubleshoot when somebody's having trouble losing weight. A lot of people will tell me things like, I've been on a ketogenic diet for a month, I haven't lost any weight. I gained 2 pounds or whatever. I've been on a ketogenic diet for 6 months. I lost 20 pounds right away, and then now I can't lose any more weight. So there's a couple things that we look at there. Number one, do they really need to lose weight? I mean, sometimes they're actually at their optimal weight. They want to be 18 again, and they're 58, and may not be realistic. Okay, so that's one thing to consider, but. You may have three individuals, as a doctor, I might have three individuals in front of me that are telling me this same story, and I've got to look at them as individual cases. So person A over here may need to tweak their diet. They may not be following the diet right. They may not be actually testing their blood ketones and getting into ketosis. They're like, well, they're high on my urine test, but they're not in their blood. And so how many of you guys have heard that? Well, my ketones are really high on my urine test, but they're not getting results. And so they may not have elevated blood ketones. They may not be in nutritional ketosis. So that's the first thing. It's simple. We just got to tweak the diet. Person B may have underlying thyroid and adrenal issues that are impacting their ability to produce metabolic energy. And that's something we've really got to address. And I'll go into that in just a second. We got to support the thyroid, support the adrenals there. And then person C may actually need more stress. All right? So person B needs less stress. Person C may need more stress. So we've got to hit a certain stress threshold to really move our metabolic machinery. So how do we add more stress? Well, fasting is a stress. So we can do alternate day fasting. One day you eat, the next day you don't. Or we might do a 5-day water fast. Or we may do one meal a day. So that's a stressor on the body that can help trigger more metabolic fat burning. Okay, get that insulin down just a little bit more to stimulate that. We can also do exercise, high intensity training, where we are stimulating growth hormone, increasing our lean body mass, which increases our metabolism. So we might add in some good exercise. We might do temperature change. So how many of you guys are crazy like me and you finish every shower with 60 seconds cold water? Okay. So like I was doing that this morning. And while I had my little 9-month-old, Joyful was like crawling around, and I'm like in the shower, my wife's watching the boys, and they're in the bathtub in the other room, and I'm like pumping. So what I do is I turn it on cold at the end, and I just kind of pump my muscles like this, because it drives circulation, you get this huge endorphin release, huge blast of growth hormones, amazing. So it's uncomfortable at first, of course, but actually embracing the discomfort, or one of my friends says, you gotta embrace the suck, all right? So you know it's gonna suck, you just gotta embrace it, you just gotta dive in. And so like I'm pumping my muscles and it's probably about 30 seconds through. I'm like, this is amazing. You know, I'm like feeling great. My daughter's like sitting up and she's like laughing at me, you know? And so I'm like, this is great. So that is one way to create a stressor on your body that now actually stimulates adaptation. Your body has to adapt. Whenever there's stress, your body's got to adapt to it. And the way it's going to adapt to that, one of the benefits is it's going to release hormones, okay, and heat shock proteins and all these cool things that will help you burn fat for fuel. So that may be another trigger that we need. Now, if somebody has adrenal fatigue, raise your hand if you heard that term, okay, or a disconnect between their brain and their adrenals, and they go ahead and they do a cold water shower, they may feel good initially, okay, but then later in the day they're gonna crash. Too much stress, overwhelm their system, all right? So, for some people this can be really beneficial. For other people, they may just start with 5 seconds of cold water or 10 seconds or something like that. So just a little bit and then gradually bump up. Now, how many of you guys have heard of the thyroid gland and how important that is? Raise your hand. So probably everybody in here, how many of you guys know somebody that has a thyroid issue? Really common, in fact, the most underdiagnosed condition out there. And as a functional medicine practitioner, I see this all the time. So go ahead and go to the next slide. So these are certain signs of an underactive thyroid. They don't always mean you have an underactive thyroid. And actually, we really shouldn't say an underactive thyroid, because what I find is that most people, actually a thyroid gland itself is producing enough hormone, but they either have an autoimmune condition that's affecting the thyroid, or they're not converting the inactive form of thyroid hormone into the active form, which is T3. But these are common things that we'll see. And another one that's not on there is actually hair loss. And how many of you guys have heard of somebody who said, I got on a ketogenic diet, started losing hair? Okay, so to me that's like red flag, red flag, red flag. Gotta test thyroid. I'm gonna show you in the next slide, not yet, how to test a thyroid, what labs need to be done. But you guys can also see there the elevated cholesterol. So a lot of times people go on a ketogenic diet, cholesterol goes up, LDL cholesterol, total cholesterol, and they're like, my cholesterol went up, you know, and they're really worried, and their medical doctor, of course, pen pad reflex, and they're giving them what? Yes, right, statin medication. However, we know that thyroid hormone, active T3, plays a big role with LDL receptor sensitivity. And so if the LDL receptor, kind of like insulin sensitivity, so if you don't have good sensitivity in that receptor, you need to produce more LDL. Does that make sense? Because LDL is important. It brings, you know, fat-soluble vitamin A, vitamin D, all these key nutrients to the, it's a boat, right? It's like literally carrying all your precious cargo to the cell. It's really, really important. So if you don't have good sensitivity in that LDL receptor, you're not getting those valuable nutrients into the cell. So now the body's like, well, I gotta produce more of these. I need more boats out there because I gotta get this precious cargo, you know, to dock. And so the thyroid hormone, this is so common, cholesterol goes up, they don't have good thyroid hormone expression, okay? And so let's go to the next slide there. These are the key labs, okay? These are the labs that need to be looked at. So a lot of times doctors are just looking at TSH, which is actually a brain hormone. It's not even the thyroid. It's a hormone that the brain tells the thyroid to produce thyroid hormone. And then sometimes they'll test T4, which is your inactive form of thyroid hormone. But the thyroid, 93% of what the thyroid produces is inactive. It's T4. The body has then got to convert it into T3. Now there's also these binding globulins that can come around and bind to your thyroid hormone, okay? Especially anybody heard of like estrogen dominance, okay? So when somebody has too much estrogen in their body, typically because of insulin resistance, but oftentimes when they have that, they can't convert, or they have too much binding globulins that grab the T3. Okay, we got plenty of time here. I'm almost finished and I got 10 minutes left. Good time for Q&A. This is great and I can take some time on this. You guys good? Everything going good? Okay, good. All right, so So anyways, there's all these different factors. Reverse T3, how many of you guys have heard of that? Reverse T3, okay? So if somebody has elevated cortisol, who's heard of cortisol, stress hormone, they might have high reverse T3. So when I look at that on a lab, I typically think, unless they're like overwhelmed by stress in their life, maybe they're going through a divorce or bankruptcy or something, I typically think if it's not something like that, chronic infection. They might have a chronic infection. And so what if they had a chronic Epstein-Barr virus infection, right? Or a parasite or something like that. That could be driving up that reverse T3, making them feel awful, and then they're gonna say, well, it's a ketogenic diet. I started losing my hair. Keto's terrible. No. We gotta address the infection, support your immune system, and it may have been too stressful, this diet change may have been too stressful for you too quickly. These are things we need to look at. Okay, vitamin D. Why aren't they testing vitamin D? Vitamin D is so important. How many of you guys ever had a vitamin D test? And how many of you guys were low in vitamin D, right? Most people are. And so, you know, it's interesting because my wife is real, she goes out and she can stay, she never sunburns. She's white, but she gets really, really dark and sunburns. For me, I get sunburned if I'm in the sun for like more than 45 minutes. So years ago, we got married in 2015, and on our honeymoon, we went to Mexico, and she was like out just sunbathing the whole time. And then for me, I got sunburnt the first day. And then after that, I was, you know, pretty much trying to reduce my sun exposure. Well, we both got labs done the like 2 weeks after. And my vitamin D was 80 nanograms per milliliter, which is like awesome, really ideal. Now, let me just give you guys the marker that doctors are gonna look for, medical doctors typically, is 30. If you're under 30, they're gonna say you're deficient. And the big thing for them is they think, well, you're at risk for osteoporosis or osteomalacia or some sort of a bone, a bone density issue. But we know that vitamin D plays a huge role in your immune function and your ability to have enough T regulatory cells so we can balance out inflammation, prevent autoimmune conditions, help your body to have a strong enough immune function too to help kill off cancer cells and things like that. So very, very important. My wife, her levels were 38. So she's somebody who loves to sunbathe, loves to get in the sun. All right, but what I found was that she actually had a vitamin D gene receptor mutation where she actually needs more sun, more vitamin D supplementation in order to get her levels to where they should be. Whereas for me, I don't, so I can go out in the sun. We actually have one of these cool vitamin D tanning beds at my house, which is really cool. Dr. Mercola used to sell them. Anybody heard of Dr. Mercola? Yeah, he told me, I spoke at a conference with him a year or two ago. He told me that he actually got a $5 million lawsuit for selling vitamin D tanning beds. Can you believe that? Can't sell them anymore. But anyways, vitamin D supplementation, very, very inexpensive, okay? Can make a huge difference in your life and your health. Now, fasting insulin, I know Amy was talking about that. That should be tested, you know? So when we're looking at all this stuff, we should definitely be testing fasting insulin. And so for some people, this is rare, okay, but with some people with thyroid issues, their fasting insulin is actually too low. These are the people that do better with like some carb ups because their insulin's too low. Insulin actually plays a role with, this is one of the good things insulin does, helps convert T4 to T3. So if we suppress that insulin too much, we might not get the right conversion there. So usually the Goldilocks, you know, the ideal optimal zone for your insulin, fasting insulin, is gonna be between 2 and 5. It's under 2 or it's trending in that area and somebody has, and it's fasting insulin, of course. And so if it's trending down around 2 and somebody's having more of these sort of thyroid symptoms, then I might have them add in some carbs in the evening once a week or twice a week or every other day, or you know, try to find the right rhythm. These are people that are more insulin sensitive. Good for them. You know, that 20% I think that you showed on that chart. And so good, great for them, and they just may need that. Of course, we want to do it with real foods, and so that's a key thing to be looking at. Iron panel. I think that's really huge. Sometimes people are anemic, they have an H. pylori infection or something like that, parasite, and they're anemic. and they're not absorbing, even though they're eating red meat, they're not absorbing the iron. So I see that often. So anyways, this is just a whole group of labs right here that if you take a picture of that and bring that into your doctor and say, hey, it's time for our regular blood work. I don't want just the regular complete blood count and, you know, everything's great. You can go home and, you know, continue to feel bad. I'd rather get all of these tests right here. Can you please run all of these tests? And they may do it, okay? And typically all of these tests can be run, and oftentimes insurance will pay for that, okay? So you can just talk to them, especially if you have a medical condition. They may pay for it. Sometimes you'll get the response that they are not going to run it. And some doctors are a little bit concerned that the insurance company is not gonna pay. And if you get all of these done and they don't pay, I mean, they're gonna bill the insurance like, I don't know, $3,000 for all these labs. You can purchase this whole package for like $300 off my website, Complete Thyroid, we call it. So cash rates are a lot lower. So if you can't get it run, you can go ahead and of course order it. And I have nutritionists, I have a coaching team that can help you guys as well. So then go ahead and go to the next slide. I also am local, so I have a clinic in Kennesaw, Georgia. So it took me about, I don't know, 45 minutes to an hour to get out here. Now that's a Saturday morning. If I tried to do this, come out here on a Friday or a Thursday, it'd have been like, I don't know, 5 hours, whatever, it depends. I gotta come down 75, that's just crazy. Okay, but if you want nutrition coaching, you know, things like that, you know, you might do like a monthly appointment or an appointment every 3 to 6 months, you know, so it's doable. Okay, I've got a great team, great chiropractor, Dr. Audrey, and then great nutrition health coach, Melissa, and I am still in my clinic seeing patients at this time, so you know, we're here to help. You can also go to my website, drjockers.com. We get over 1 million unique visitors. Isn't that amazing? Just, you know, started it, just trying to get this information out, but it's really grown. It's been a blessing, and we have a lot of free gifts that can help you out there as well. Okay, so how much time do I have? What, 2 minutes? 2 minutes? All right, guys. Well, hopefully that was helpful, and if you have questions, I'm going to be hanging around for just a little bit, but I will be leaving a little bit early because I can't let my wife, our nanny couldn't work today, and I can't let my wife have all three kids. She's going to be really mad at me if she's going to have all three kids all day long, so can't let that happen. All right, thanks so much.